Well, it's a breakthrough that will change the way we identify and treat cancer, and Australian researchers have been at the heart of it. They're part of an international team which has identified dozens of genes that contribute to the development of the disease, which they hope will increase the survival rate even further. So, for our focus interview this week, we speak with the Cancer Council Australia CEO, Professor Ian Olver.
Professor, thanks for joining us. So I'd like to start by asking you about a hugely exciting research breakthrough that's been looking at the faulty DNA, if you like, that can cause some of these cancers. It was an international effort, 1,000 scientists all up, including some from Australia. What did they find?
All cancer is a series of changes in genes that cause cells to grow out of control. So what they're looking for is the patterns of these changes, so they may be able to predict which patients get cancer and then target those changes to try and treat the cancer.
What are the practical implications then? Will this change the treatment for cancer?
Well, very much so, because we're actually looking at targeted therapies, or what's sometimes called personalised medicine. We'll be able to target the treatment specifically to each individual's cancer according to the genes that are abnormal, and that means that there'll be less side effects, because we're not going to be targeting the normal cells, we're going to be targeting the cancer cells specifically, so we should have a higher success rate.
What are the sorts of side effects that we could see eliminated here? And I guess the big question for people who are living with cancer is, how quickly could they be eliminated?
We've already had some of these treatments, drugs like Herceptin in breast cancer, for example, which it works in about 25% of breast cancers, is a targeted therapy. And at the moment it's being added to chemotherapy, but as more are discovered, they'll probably be used more on their own. And instead of the side effects that came from chemotherapy that just killed any cell that was dividing at the time, you have some side effects. Some people get high temperatures, some people get some organ dysfunctions, but it's not the same as the nausea and vomiting and the blood counts going down and the hair loss that we're used to with conventional chemotherapy.
Research of this nature is critical, but so are screening programs. I understand a new study by the Australian Medical Journal released yesterday calls for the National Bowel Cancer Screening Program to be expanded. That, of course, will cost money. Should this be an election issue?
If fully implemented, that could save between 20 and 30 lives per week from bowel cancer. So we know it's effective. The new research shows that double the number of people are being diagnosed at an early stage when their cancer is more easily curable.
20 to 30 lives a week, those figures are really quite staggering. It's pretty hard, I imagine, too, to put a price on those figures if you're a politician.
Well, I think it is, but also it's far more expensive to treat established bowel cancer than to distribute screening kits. So it makes good economic sense as well as saving lives.
What about the cancer fight more broadly? We gauge our progress in this battle by looking at the statistics. Are the numbers of diagnosed cases going up or down, and what's happening in terms of fatalities?
The good news is the death rate is coming down, and that's because of screening and it's because of better treatments. So for anyone who gets cancer today, about two-thirds of those people will still be alive in 5 years' time. No, we've got to do better than that, but it shows you it's becoming a disease that more people live with.
Another really encouraging statistic is that Australian cancer patients actually have the highest survival rate of anywhere in the world. Why is that?
Well, I think the same two factors are in play here. We've got three population screening programs in breast cancer, cancer of the cervix and bowel cancer, and we adopt the best of the new treatments fairly early and make them available to the population so that we're keeping up with the advances in treatment and taking advantage of that.
For all the advances, for all the breakthroughs, those living with cancer really want an answer to just one question. Are we any closer to a cure?
Well, it won't be a cure, because cancer is a couple of hundred diseases, but one at a time, I think we will get control of them and eventually be able to cure more and more of them. And I think the targeted therapies, now we know what causes cancer, we can actually look very closely at switching off the things that switch it on in the first place.
So there is some light then at the end of the tunnel?
there's a lot of light at the end of the tunnel, and we're seeing this shift into the treatment by targeting the genes and their products.
Professor, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.